In this video, we're going to cover the overall function of the Dixon DX60 Hygienic Tanker Valve. Depending on the configuration of the valve, you may or may not have the cover on it. Remove the aluminum cover from the valve. Rotate the cover nut counterclockwise until the nut is disengaged. Remove the cover from the valve. The next step will be to connect the process line to the inlet/outlet of the valve. Remove the bevel seat nut using a 3-inch bevel seat hex nut wrench. Loosen the nut. Remove the nut and end cap. We are simulating connecting your hose to the valve by using this fitting. Connect your hose to the valve and thread the nut to the connection on the valve. Tighten the hex nut with a 3-inch bevel seat hex wrench. To open the valve, place your fingers on the cam arms and pull in a downward motion until the cam arms are released. Reading the instructions on the handle, align the arrow with the red indicator on the bonnet. Pull the plunger stem open towards you, rotate the handle until the arrow is lined up with the green indicator. Press on the end of the valve stem to make sure it is in the locked position. The valve is now in the locked position for any handle rotation except for the indicated unlocked position. When emptying or loading of the tanker is complete, you can now close the valve. Move the arrow indicator back to the red indicator on the bonnet and push the stem in to close the valve. Grab the cam arms and push upward and in until the cam arms are locked and engaged. The valve is now in the locked position. The valve is now in the closed and locked position, and you can remove the hose assembly and nut from the valve. Using the same hex nut wrench, loosen the nut from the valve. Remove the hose assembly from the valve. Reinstall the valve port end cap and bevel seat nut. Notice the concave side of the end cap should be facing out. Place the end cap inside the hex nut and install onto the valve. Tighten the hex nut with the hex nut wrench. After you have removed the hose and the end cap is connected, you can place the cover back onto the valve. When installing the cover, be sure to visually align the hole into the top of the cover with the tap hole on the handle. Rotate the cover as needed to align the two holes. Thread the cover nut back on and tighten. If you are using a safety seal, place the seal through one of the many holes on the nut and thread it through the eye bolt on the back of the cover. On the body of the valve, you will find a laser marked QR code, which when scanned by your smartphone, will direct you to complete installation and operation manual, which includes a list of all spare parts and complete assembly, disassembly instructions. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, contact us at dixonvalve.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.